In 1910s in Russia, when every single school after the second First World War was destroyed, and as a result, there were no aids that children had. So it's a very interesting example of how you can do these tables without doing any only you just need to know addition and you can do these tables. So what the process I'm going to show you here. So basically what you do is you touch any two fingers. You count the number of fingers on top, these three fingers on top, these three two fingers on top. All right. These two fingers here and these three fingers here. Okay. Upar ki jo the three fingers and two fingers, we're going to multiply. Right. And the bottom fingers, we are going to add and then multiply by 10. Seven times eight is 56. All right. So now how are you going to mathematically prove that it always works? Please go take time on your paper or do whatever and show. And I think it will be a very interesting exercise. So the reason what I was saying, and let's make sure that we understand what we mean by proof. Proof is that it should work for everything mathematically. So let's assume one of our fingers, that number we call X, the other finger we call Y. This is X and this is Y. Okay. So the number of fingers on top are how much? 10 minus X. Okay. And the number of fingers on the other side similarly will be 10 minus Y. All right. Correct. So this is, then you have three fingers on top. If this is seven, you have three fingers on top. You have eight, you have two fingers on top. 10 minus 8 and 10 minus 7. All right. So multiplying that. So you multiply that. So what will you get? You will get 100 minus 10X minus 10Y plus XY. All right. I hope you can see that. Then fingers at the bottom. How many are though? The number of fingers on the bottom, let me change color. I'll color with green. The bottom fingers are with green. They are X minus 5. All right. Because you have seven fingers and the bottom fingers are two. So X minus 5 is 2. And then he's adding that to how many fingers here? Y minus 5. All right. And then he is multiplying all of this by 10. Correct? X plus Y minus 10 times 10, which is 10X plus 10Y minus 100. Okay. Now, if you add this green thing to this red thing, what will you get? You can clearly see all these terms will cancel. And finally, you just get X, Y. For bottom, it will be X minus 5. And he's adding the two fingers and then multiplying it by 10. And you add these two things, you will get X, Y. So that's why this thing works. This is the proof. This is what we call the formal proof.